Let us see the next question. An importer requested his bank to extend for forward contract of US$25,000, which is due for maturity on 31st of October, for a further period of 6 months. The other details are as under. Contracted rate is $1 is equal to ₹71. The US dollar quoted on 31st of October, spot exchange rate is given, 6 months forward premium is given. Margin money for buying and selling rate is given, 0.086% and 0.15% respectively. Compute the cost to importer in respect of the extension of the forward contract and the new forward contract rate. That is the question. Everybody just go through the question. We'll discuss it, how to do answer. Now the very first thing that we will do is we'll try to have understanding of the question. Language of the question starts like this. An importer requested his bank to extend for the forward contract of US$25,000, which is due for maturity on 31st of October, for a further period of 6 months. What does it mean, friends? It means that on some date, which is that date we do not know, a forward contract was entered upon for 31st of October for sell of rupees and purchase of dollar. How much? 25,000. Sir, how did you come to know it is sell rupees, purchase dollar? Because the language of the question says that, say, it is an importer who requested the bank. Means we understand that, say, the importer is required to make payment in foreign currency. So the forward contract must have been entered upon for conversion of the rupees into dollar. Okay. Now, for this, the contracted rate is provided to us, 71 rupees per dollar. So there was a contract to purchase the dollar at the rate of 71 rupees. Okay. Now the question says like this, that an importer requested his bank to extend for forward contract of $25,000, which is due for maturity on 31st of October, for a further period of 6 months. The other details are provided to us. Means, friends, information is provided to us that on 31st of October itself, the customer has come to the bank for the purpose of extension of the contract. Means, on 31st of October, again two transactions are required to be entered upon. One transaction will be entered upon for the purpose of cancellation of the original contract. So it would be sell-off dollar spot transaction. It will be sell-off dollar and purchase of rupees. And one will be the 6 months forward contract. Maybe 31st of March. Okay, 6 months. And that forward contract will be conversion of the rupees into dollar. Like that, so we understand for the purpose of cancellation, one contract will be entered upon and that would be spot. And another will be forward contract for 6 months for conversion of the rupees into dollar. Okay. So over here, we understand that, say, these are the transactions which have been entered upon as per the given information. Now, which rates will be applicable? Let us have an understanding of the same. This time you can see that, so the information is provided to us, which is something new for us. Margin money for buying and selling rate are 0.086% and 0.15% respectively. Now let us have understanding of said this information. Dear students, we have to understand something like this. Bank, customer, and interbank market. These are the three things that we have. Basically, when a customer is doing a transaction with the bank, then in that case, so the bank is entering into the similar transaction in the international market. If at all the customer says that I want to sell dollar and purchase rupees, that is, I will give dollar to you, then the bank is entering into the international market for the same transaction for sell dollar and purchase rupees. The bank is not keeping the risk on itself. The bank is transferring the risk in the international market. If at all the customer is doing a transaction for sell rupees and purchase dollar, then bank is also doing the same transaction, sell rupees and purchase dollar. Of course, you can understand and say, reverse of this transaction is entered upon by the bank. That is, sell rupees and purchase dollar. Sell dollar and purchase rupees. So from bank point of view, what happens at say, these are the two opposite transactions which have been entered upon by bank. These are the two opposite transactions which have been entered upon by the bank. That is what we understand. So bank is basically purchasing rupees and selling dollar, and over here selling rupees and purchasing dollar. So these two transactions will be squared off and the bank will not be having say any exchange rate fluctuation risk. Over here again sell rupees and purchase rupees, both of them will be squared off from the bank point of view. So basically what happens at the bank is only having an advantage or only having some kind of the profit equal to the margin money. Margin money is, in a simple way, we understand and say the way we have a kind of like the brokerage when we are doing a transaction, say through any stock exchange. Let us say that say we are doing a transaction in the stock exchange. Then in that case, National Stock Exchange or Bombay Stock Exchange is not having say any income as such, other than a kind of transaction cost. We understand that say if at all I purchase say shares of Reliance company, let us say an amount of rupees 1000. Then in that case, I have to pay 1000 rupees plus say some transaction cost of let us say 20 rupees. So that 20 rupees is the only additional income that say the National Stock Exchange is able to get. Now 1000 rupees is the price which I pay. So that amount is going to a trader who is selling that security to me. Of course, he is also required to pay some transaction cost. So 1000 rupees minus 20 is the amount that say he is getting. So overall, there is a 40 rupees of the income that say the stock exchange is able to earn. Similarly, over here, say we have been provided with the information about the margin. Means that is what say the kind of say the additional charges which bank is collecting from the customer. That is the amount of the additional charges which the bank is collecting from the customer. That is what we understand. So friends, in the spot transaction, sell of dollar and purchase of rupees. So for every $1, you will get less amount of rupees. So 70.32, and in that, so the margin will be adjusted. And for 31st of March, it is sell rupees purchase dollar. So what will happen? So this premium information will be adjusted to the spot rate, and then whatever the answer that we get, in that further margin will be adjusted to compute the relevant rate applicable over here. This is what we understand. Whatever the exchange rate that we calculate over here, that will be compared with 71. We understand that the sell rupees means at the rate of 71 rupees you are going to buy a dollar. So over here, the purchase rupees is net of the transaction cost, that is net of the margin, is less than 71. Then in that case, say there will be a loss. If it is greater than 71, then in that case, there will be a profit. So please write an answer. In that, write down first point. As per the given information, comma,
an Indian company entered into a forward contract for 31st of October, comma, for seller rupees purchase dollar. In bracket write down, on which date it was entered upon is not given. Bracket over. It was entered upon at the rate of 71 rupees per dollar. Second point, on 31st of October, highlight the date on 31st of October, Indian company will enter into following transactions. In that return, spot transaction, sell dollar, purchase rupees. In bracket, to cancel original forward contract. And the next is 6 months forward contract. And that 6 months forward contract will be sell of rupees and purchase of dollar. Third, for entering into spot transaction, comma, we have to take into account margin money. In bracket I'm writing, similar to transaction cost. / brokerage. With paragraph write down, for forward contract, comma, we will consider premium / discount. Over here the premium is given, otherwise we may be provided with the discount, premium / discount, and further margin money.
So this is a note only for understanding. Now let us do the answer. Working note number one, calculation of rate applicable for cancellation of original forward contract. Everybody is requested to pay attention now. 70.32/70.63 rupees per dollar. Okay. Now this is the rate applicable. So on 31st of October, spot transaction, it is sell of dollar and purchase of rupees. So for every $1, you will get less amount of rupees. So 70.32, okay. Now friends, you can see that the information is provided to us. Margin money for buying and selling rate. Now this is required to be understood with respect to the domestic currency. So when you buy rupees, at that time you will get less amount of the rupees. So what will happen, friends, over here? 70.32, because you are going to buy rupees, minus 0.086%. This is the rate which will be applicable for the spot transaction for sell of dollar and purchase of rupees. That is what we understand. So we understand that, so the rate applicability will be 70.32 minus 0.086%. That is always provided to us with respect to the domestic currency. So 70.2595 rupees per dollar. Okay. So calculation of profit or loss due to cancellation of original forward contract. So we understand that, say, original transaction was sell rupees, purchase dollar, and for the purpose of cancellation, it is sell of dollar and purchase of rupees. 70.2595. So overall profit or loss. Purchase rupees means received. 70.2595. Sell of rupees means payment, 71. Multiplied with 25,000. So 70.2595 minus 71, that comes to 0.7405 into 25,000. So there is a loss of 18,512.5. That is the amount of the loss that you have. And the first question speaks that only we are required to compute the cost to the importer in respect of the extension. So this is what, so the cost which is required to be paid for the purpose of extension. Now answer for the second question,
What is the new forward rate? So answer for the second question. Calculation of new forward rate. Now there are three things that we have to consider. Spot exchange rate 70.32 / 70.63 rupees per dollar. Then 6 months premium 0.86% / 0.98%. And last is the margin for buying 0.086% and for selling 0.15%. So first of all, we are required to find the forward exchange rate. Forward exchange rate. It is 70.32 plus 0.86%. As it is premium, it means that the dollar currency has appreciated. 70.32 plus 0.86%. So 70.927 9248. Slash, it is 70.63 plus 0.98%. So 71.32 32 double. This is what we understand is the forward exchange rate. Now, the transaction in which you are interested into is sell of rupees and purchase of dollar. Why? Because you have imported goods. So you have to see that, say, with respect to the domestic currency, what you are doing, you sell domestic currency. So the selling rate margin will be applicable. What is the selling rate margin? It is 0.15%. 71.3222 plus 0.15%. This is what we understand is the rate which will be applicable to buy dollar. 71.3222 plus 0.15%. Because you have to pay more to buy a dollar. In case of the buying margin, we deducted. Why? Because we understand that, say, we are going to receive less. So the buying margin would be subtracted. However, the selling margin would be added. So that comes to 71.4292. Rupees per dollar. This is the rate which will be applicable to buy dollar. Read our answer. So friends, over here, summarizing the answer, that in case of the buying, you are required to deduct the margin, and if at all in case of selling, you have to add the margin. Write down a note for this. Whenever buying margin and selling margin are to be adjusted, comma, then buying margin is deducted and selling margin would be added. Full stop. Further write down in that. It is required to be understood from domestic currency point of view. Full stop. If domestic currency is sold, comma, add selling margin and if domestic currency is purchased, comma, deduct buying margin. Friends, in my opinion, so this is something which is important from your revision point of view. So just be careful.